After having ridden it for quite a number of laps on the Bajaj track, which boasts a very long straight, I think it can safely lay claim to the being the fastest Pulsar yet. I clocked 149 kmph on the speedo, on the digital speedo, which is quite pretty accurate. RS200 feels like an iteration. It feels like a natural evolution, a progressive step in taking the Pulsar forward into the next, into the near future. So that is a good thing, because there are people who are not receptive to big changes. It feels like a gradual evolution. The styling is cool, the styling looks good, the full fairing is something unprecedented. And the engine has gotten a lot more refined. The performance is a lot better than what we have experienced before, and the gearbox is a lot slicker. There are no false neutrals or no missed gears at all. So I think that it is a good progress. It is a step in the right direction. For me, the best feature on the RS200 would undoubtedly be the ABS. After that, at a distant second would come the perimeter frame. The perimeter frame, it has given the bike a newfound rigidity that we have complained about a lot in the past, especially in the Pulsar 220, not so much in the NS200, but the perimeter frame has given it newfound rigidity and stability in corners, so that's a good thing. But by far, the ABS is a standout feature when you are braking hard, especially in our Indian road conditions where the roads are not that good. It makes a lot of difference, especially for new riders. And as for the dual projector headlamps, I am pretty sure that it will work as all projector headlamps do, which is great.